On this video, we're talking about mastering your audio in Adobe Premiere Pro, and that starts right now. Hello, friends and family. Ryan Camp here. Thank you so much for joining me today. This channel is all about learning and growing as a filmmaker. So please like, share, and subscribe if you haven't already, and let's become better filmmakers together. Now, on today's video, we're going to be talking about mastering your audio in Adobe Premiere Pro. If you're not familiar, audio mastering is basically the process of putting the finishing touches on all of the audio files in your project. In this case, every audio file that lives on your timeline, we're going to be affecting them all at once, adding consistency, we're going to be boosting signal levels, adding clarity, and getting the project ready for distribution to your viewers. Now, before we get started, I would like to shout out this video's sponsor, which is Epidemic Sound. Epidemic Sound is the best place on the web for royalty-free music and sound effects for video creators and filmmakers just like you. Just head down into the description and follow the link for a free 30-day trial and tell them that Ryan sent you. I use Epidemic Sound on almost every video project I create, and I highly recommend it. Now let's go ahead and head over to Adobe Premiere Pro, and we'll go ahead and get started with this quick tutorial on audio mastering. Okay guys, as you can see here, I have my video clip with audio here on the timeline and is on audio channel 1. Let me go ahead and play this audio clip for you so you can go ahead and hear what it sounds like before we start doing any editing or mastering. Hey, give me a call back as soon as you get this. I'm a little bit freaked out. Came home and the door was standing wide open. Just want to make sure everything's okay. Make sure you got to the airport all right. Okay, as you can see here at the bottom of your audio timeline, you have a channel called Mix. That is where the audio mastering is going to take place. It's going to affect all of the audio files on your timeline. But we want to go ahead and add individual effects and equalization to our individual clips before we master everything. So let's go ahead and select this audio file here, go to our audio tab and go to the effects. We're going to pick balanced male voice since this is a dialogue heavy clip. Hey, give me a call back as soon as you get this. I'm a little bit freaked out. Came home and the door was standing wide open. Just want to make sure everything's okay. Make sure you got to the airport all right. As you can see, it boosted the levels of this clip quite a bit. There's a little bit of reverb in there, so let's go ahead and add a reduce reverb effect to this. Very subtle. Hey, give me a call back as soon as you get this. I'm a little bit freaked out. Came home and the door was standing wide open. Just want to make sure everything's okay. Make sure you got to the airport all right. Now this is all just examples of stuff that we're going to do before we do mastering. And while you're here in the audio tab, you'll see that we have a channel for mix here in these gray boxes. You'll notice that over in the editing tab, if you go to the audio mixer, you don't see this mix channel here. So it's kind of hard to find. So you go back to the audio tab. We have our channels here. We're going to go to mix. In these gray boxes, we can add submixes. We can add effects. And this is where we're going to find the option to add mastering to our mix channel. Now, you can add this to any channel, but when you add it to the mix channel, it's going to affect the overall project. Every audio file on the project is going to be affected. So we're going to click one of these down arrows here. And then we're going to add mastering. It's under the special category. Now, when we double click into the mastering, it's going to bring up an effects box here. Now, my screen recording software is refusing to display this audio mastering panel that pops up. So I'm going to put an image up on the screen for you to take a look at. It's not the best image, but it's the only one I could find. As you can see, we have several options here to manipulate our mastering track. And this is what I normally do when I master a track. I go up here to the presets and pick subtle clarity. I lower the reverb a little bit by about 10%. The widener I increase by about 10%. And the output gain I increase a little bit. Let's take a look at what this sounds like.
I'm a little bit freaked out. Came home and the door was standing wide open. Just want to make sure everything's okay. Make sure you got to the airport all right.
And as you can see there, if you take a look, when we play this back, audio level 1 is actually peaking, but in the mix, it's not. That means our mastering effect has done its job. It's compressed the audio. It's kept that channel from peaking. It's turned things that may have been inaudible a little bit more audible. So it's just basically adding consistency to the audio quality and the sound. Now, of course, my way isn't the only way to do this, or the right way, or the best way to do this, but now that you know how to bring up the audio mastering effect, I highly recommend that you grab some video files that contain audio, bring this effect up, and start playing around with this and find the thing that works best for you in your situations. And there you have it, guys, a pretty simple tip to help you guys unlock a little bit more power in Adobe Premiere Pro as it involves audio mixing and mastering and getting your audio levels just where you want them. Hopefully this is something you guys didn't even know existed, and now a whole new window of opportunity has opened for you. There's tons of different things you can do with this, affecting your sound effects, your voiceovers, whatever it is. This is the key to getting your entire project sounding loud and consistent, which is what we want. If you guys found this video beneficial, please give it a like. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And the most important thing, if you want to help support this channel, please share this video on social media with your friends and family. It really means a lot and really helps this channel grow. And I thank you in advance. The holidays are quickly approaching, and I'm still filming my new short film, The Trinity. That's why I'm doing these quick tutorials like this here at the end of the year, just to give you guys some content while I work my butt off in the background. Thank you to our channel members, David Coles, Paul Kane, Clive Bishop. Thank you guys so much for your continued support. Thank you guys for coming along on this filmmaking journey with me. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next video. Bye-bye.